Adab, and welcome to the cuisine of the Nawabs. I'm here at the Holiday Inn, and today, after a stint of South Indian and Rajasthani food, we are going to take you to taste the Awadhi cuisine. So, let's get ready because there's a lot of things in store for us. Shall we start? I'm sitting in this beautiful surroundings, greenery all around, at a restaurant aptly called The Village. And here with me, I have Chef Manjit Singh.
Hello.
Welcome, Chef.
Hello.
And it's nice of you to spend some time with us, because I'm given to understand that Chef has taken a few of his recipes from his fantastic menu, and he's going to show us something about Awadhi cuisine. What are you preparing for us today, Chef?
Ma'am, today we are preparing galoti kebab,
which
is made up of mutton mince.
Okay.
And another is dahi gosht. It's a dumb folk cuisine which has been originated.
But you know, I heard some, you know, we're talking about tradition and myths and legacies come down the line.
Yes.
I heard that a little bit of these myths regarding this dumb folk cuisine.
Actually, dumb folk, we are talking about the biryanis. Mm-hmm. So there are two stories what I personally know about the biryani.
Okay,
First is that when that Taj Mahal was being built,
okay,
there was approximately 8 to 10,000 people were working. In the history we say, we come to know that there are 20,000 people working every day.
Oh my
gosh. So they make a big, huge, large handi, and they put all the rice, vegetables, potato, meat, oil and everything. And they have cooked very gently.
Okay.
Because that they want to that everybody can have food, and in the same time it doesn't get spoiled and can be used, reused.
Alright, that's a very interesting story, one of the stories.
So they have covered, and it's a lot of flavorful, and one day that king was passing through it, and he's got a lot of good smell, and he asked, what is this? So they told that they are making food for the labor.
Alright.
So he liked it, he wanted that he should taste it. He tasted and he'll loved it so much that he wanted to introduce in his own
cuisine. His own court. Oh my gosh.
So this is
so all that rich biryani which you have, this is one part of the story where during the Mughal times, maybe the emperor saw the laborers eating it and decided.
Yes.
And the other story?
The other story is that once there was a shortage of food.
Oh my gosh.
In the country. So that emperor there was there, Nawab.
Okay, the Nawab.
So he wanted to really help out the people and wanted to feed them. So what he did again, that they have got a big handi, and they put all the vegetables and spices and meat, and it's again in the same way they have made it. It's called biryani.
So whatever the story, I love biryani, but today Chef is going to introduce us to two other of the cuisines, that is the galoti kebab.
Yes.
And the dahi gosht.
Dahi gosht.
Are you ready to start? Now we're here to learn about the preparation of food which is fit for the kings. With me I have Chef Manjit.
Yes, ma'am.
So Chef, what have you for us?
Today we will start with galoti kebab.
Galoti kebab.
It's of Awadhi cuisine.
Awadhi
cuisine, and it has been started from royal food like the emperors they used to have.
Don't I feel very much
so
royal?
Today I'll show you the ingredients, what all they have. We have got mutton mince. lemons. We have green chili.
Uh-huh.
We have ginger garlic paste.
Okay.
We have salt.
Mm-hmm.
We have cardamom powder.
That's cardamom powder.
Cardamom powder. We have this is green cardamom powder.
Okay.
This is pure ghee.
Mm-hmm.
This is besan.
Mm-hmm.
Red chili powder. And this is a raw papaya.
Uh-huh.
This is grated raw papaya.
Oh, so you grate the raw papaya.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And this is, we have what, fresh coriander leaves. And this is mace powder.
Mace powder.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, they really sound unique. So I'm just waiting to learn how he's going to start.
So first of all, we will mix the ingredients.
As he says, is we're going to get ready to mix the ingredients. So
now we will mix the ingredients. This is step one. We'll put mutton mince.
Right.
Take mutton mince. And
then now this would be for one portion.
Yes, ma'am. We will make it for one portion.
Fine.
Then we will put a little bit mace powder.
That's
just a pinch.
A pinch of that.
Pinch of that. Then put a little bit besan.
Uh-huh.
Besan is used for
that's to bind.
Binding.
Oh, yes, sir.
For the binding.
Uh-huh.
Then we'll actually this Avdi cuisine we have got a very nice called kakori kebab. And
uh-huh.
It has got a interesting story.
Okay.
That it is Kakuri is a place in Uttar Pradesh.
Uh-huh.
Where you have heard that Kakuri Kand also.
Oh yes.
So it was that Kakuri kebab is originated from there, and it is from the Hazrat Dargah. There is a Dargah of Hazrat Shah, and there it is made first. Kakuri
kebab.
Oh, so
it's basically a very Muslim origin.
Yes, ma'am. It's an again
kebab.
It's a religious thing like that. So the origin of Kakuri kebab is from that, and that is the it has got. A very famous in Avdi cuisine also.
Oh, kakori kebab. So that is kakori kebab, which has a lot of religious significance.
Mm.
And we are making galoti kebab.
Galoti kebab, ma'am.
Is there any story behind the galoti kebab?
Ma'am, galoti is again, it's a place name.
Oh, that's
Uttar
a Pradesh. Place.
It's a place name where it has originated, ma'am.
Hmm, I know the Nawabs really love their
love
food.
The
they love
and this in the olden days, like Nawabs, they used to call the chefs, they were known as Bavarchis or Khansamas.
Okay.
So they used to make this type of things to get the recognition from the Nawabs and us. So they used to make those things.
Alright, so the Bavarchi. Now I'm not going to call him chef, I'm going to call him Bavarchi. We are in the Nawab kitchen.
We'll put a little
chilies.
Bit of green chili. It's according to your taste, means.
So you like it extra spicy?
Yes, yes, you can add some green chili.
Mm-hmm.
Then we will add ginger garlic paste.
That's about
2 teaspoons.
2 teaspoons of ginger garlic. It's already pre-mixed in.
Yes, ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
And salt, it's.
Oh, yes, the seasoning without salt, I think no food tastes
yes,
good.
Yes, ma'am. And we'll add this raw papaya.
Why do we add the papaya?
It's used as a tenderizer also. It softens the meat.
It softens, yes, I did hear about that. So a raw papaya is very good
yes,
to be added in most
it's
meats
most
to make it
meats.
Tender.
To make it tender.
Oh, this is the ghee, the rich part of the, I'm sure the Nawabs would have loved
yes,
it.
Ma'am.
And so that's about a teaspoon?
Finally, yes ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
And finally we will add a lot of fresh coriander.
Coriander leaves. They're very coarsely chopped.
Yes ma'am.
Okay.
It's not a finely chopped ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
Then we will mix it.
Now think of those lovely attractive kebabs which come onto your table.
Yes.
And it starts with the mixing and the marination. So when you mix it and marinate, chef,
yes,
do you have to keep it for some time?
Yes, ma'am. It's already always advisable to keep the keep it for the marination for some time because
uh-huh.
it helps that it flavors are infused in that.
Okay.
Apart from that, that meat get tenderized
mm-hmm.
and it takes that flavor of the all the spices and herbs.
Okay. Now that's the secret why your kebabs are so soft and juicy. So all in the marination and it's in